Hi, this is Ashok Anand. Now I am going to explain about fertilizer technology. Fertilizer is the substance which is mixed with soil to improve the plant growth and yield. And it is mainly used in the unseen farmers. And this fertilizer improving by adding chemicals, it is known as synthetic fertilizer. And there are two types of fertilizer. It is natural fertilizer and synthetic fertilizer. And fertilizer is improving the quality and also quantity of the foods. And these are some raw materials used in the fertilizer technology. It is most commonly in nitrogen and phosphorus and potassium and sulfur. There are also secondary nutrients also present, which is get from limestone. In this limestone, there is calcium carbonate and calcium sulfate and magnesium and sulfur. And this is the process of fertilizer manufacturing. And this is ammonia, hydrocarbon feed plus hydrogen, H2O and air is the raw materials for producing ammonia. And these are gives process and it gives the ammonia. And this ammonia is used in many manufacturing process like urea and GAN and NPK, nitro phosphate manufacturing and ammonia phosphate and super phosphate. This ammonia first goes to urea manufacturing. There is the for ammonia is the main raw material for manufacturing urea. Then it goes to CAN. It's a calcium ammonium nitrate. We have to give calcium carbonate as a raw material for production CAN, and here the ammonia is the major raw material for the production of CAN. That is calcium ammonium nitrate, and then this ammonia goes to NPK manufacturing process. NPK means nitrous, potassium, and phosphorus. Here the phosphate rock and is the main raw material for this production of NPK. And we have to add an additional and secondary nutrients like magnesium, sulfur, calcium carbonate and manganese like this. And then the ammonia used for in mixed acid products. Here also phosphate rock is the raw material for this process, and we have to give micronutrients, potassium, magnesium and sulfur. Then this ammonia is the main raw material for ammonium phosphate also. Here this ammonium phosphate is produced by using ammonia. And next one is nitric acid. H2O and air plus ammonia is the main raw material for producing nitric acid. This nitric acid is used in many processes like manufacturing of CAN and NPK fertilizers and ammonium phosphate. And first is main raw material for calcium ammonium nitrate. Here we have to add a calcium carbonate also. Then it goes to NPK fertilizers. Here the phosphate rock is the raw material and also the nitric acid used for this process to produce NPK fertilizers. And then it goes to the mixed acid process. Here it is having a major role in this process. And then the sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid is most commonly used in many production areas, and it is manufacturing from sulfur and hydrogen H2O. This is the main raw material for process of sulfuric acid, and this sulfuric acid is used in mixed acid and ammonium phosphate production and super phosphate production. To produce a super phosphate, the raw material is phosphate rock. Then the sulfuric acid is also used in the manufacturing of phosphoric acid also. This is main raw material for phosphoric acid. Here the sulfuric acid and H2O and phosphate rock. These are the main raw materials for phosphoric acid. This phosphoric acid is used in the NPK fertilizers and also ammonium phosphate and super phosphate manufacturing. And these are the whole manufacturing process of fertilizers. And there is some catalysts are used in this process because to remove or to increase the reaction purposes we are using catalyst. And in the ammonia manufacturing process, the following catalysts are involved: the cobalt oxide and molybdenum oxide and zinc oxide for sulfur removal. This hydrocarbon having more sulfur, so that we have to remove the sulfur from the hydrocarbon feed to produce ammonia. So that we are using the catalyst like molybdenum oxide and cobalt oxide and zinc oxide. Then the nickel oxide is used to primary and secondary reforming. There is also reforming process in the ammonia production. So the nickel oxide is used to do reforming, and nickel oxide catalyst for methanization. This process also the nickel oxide is used. And then iron promoted for ammonia synthesis. And the catalyst involving in nitric acid production is platinum and rhodium catalyst. These are main catalyst in the nitric acid production. Then for sulfuric acid production, we are using vanadium oxide is the catalyst. And a catalyst usually is not a part of raw material, it is a part of equipment that is related to nature of reactor in this industries. It is about the nature of equipment. And other raw materials are also used in production of fertilizer industries. And there are in the fertilizer industries, they are using water as a main raw material for many processes, for cooling and other reaction to produce nitric acid and ammonia and sulfuric acid. There is use of water is main raw material. So the main raw material in the fertilizer industry is H2O. And these are some inputs, and these are some sources, and these are purpose of the input. First of all, the water is the water. It is get from ground source and lakes and rivers. It is a source of water, and it is used in cooling tower for cooling purpose. It is used in the condenser and so on, so on. So it is used in cooling tower and steam generating in the boilers. Boilers, we are using water only, we can produce a steam. And cleaning purpose and floor cleaning and equipment cleaning, it is water is important. And fuel. Fuel is to produce a heat energy to combustion and produce a steam. And this is from fuel oil as a source. And purpose is for combustion and steam generating. And the next one is steam. Steam is the main in all the industries for heating and other purposes. Stripping also done by the steam, and it is source is water. It is heated water and it will form a steam. And to heat the wooden pieces and solar power we are using to produce a steam. And the purpose is heating and reforming is the main purpose of steam. And these are some process in manufacturing, in fertilizer manufacturing. These are some important processes. First is stripping, absorption, adsorption, crystallization, evaporation and leaching and pulling. First, stripping is the physical separation process. It is done by packed column. In industries uses, they are separating vapor by counter current and co-current. And it is remove one or two components from the liquid. And another one is absorption. Absorption is also a separation process. It separates separates things from gas form. For example, it is the column. In some industries produce gases, it may have ammonia. Ammonia is soluble in water, so this process is a absorption. This is the input of gas from industries. This is output gas. We are giving a water in top of the column. It is sprayed in this type. By passing gas, there is a liquid gas contact in this column. So the ammonia is soluble in water, so that the water is the main solvent for this process. Ammonia mixed with water, we can get a bottom in the column. NH3 solution in a liquid form, and here the waste gas out. This is an example of absorption, and another one is adsorption. Adsorption is also a separation process. It separates liquids or solids which is present in solution by using a solid that is a activated carbon is the main example for adsorption, and crystallization is the formation of solids from liquid. This is artificial or natural process to form a solids from concentrated solutes. And this is the crystallization, and there is a forming in a small amount of crystals by lowering a temperature. When reduce the temperature, it will form a crystals. That's a crystallization. And leaching is the extraction of minerals from the solids by using dissolve the solids into the water. We can extract the minerals from the solids. That's a leaching process. And prilling process is the mainly used in the urea production. Prilling processes means molten stage urea is converted into a solid particles by spraying it. This is the column, this is a tower, prilling tower. Here we give molten urea. Here the urea is 99%. It is in a liquid state, and here we are giving air. This is air outlet. Here the sphere is used for separating, and here the air is mingled with this liquid and it produces a urea granules. This urea granules in round shape, this is a small round shape, and this is the main process in the prilling tower. And then next process is evaporation. Evaporation is the process in this evaporation they are using liquid to evaporate and to concentrate the solution. And this is the main process in the evaporation process. And there are some major hazards in the manufacturing of fertilizer. And in nitric acid manufacturing process, it a failure of equipments, because the nitric acid react with iron, it will produce a corrosion. So that is the main problem in the nitric acid plant, and we have to reduce this corrosion by adding a paint and other some process. And the explosion of hazard due to air and ammonia mixing. There is many area where contact, air contact and ammonia is happening, so that it will explosion it will occur. So that this is the major hazards. And another one is explosion of nitrite and nitrate salts. These are the major hazards in nitric acid process. And then ammonium nitrate production, there is a oxidizing agent is ammonium nitrate. So we have to give a more precautions for the manufacturing of ammonium nitrate, and transportation and also storage also we have to give a more care. These are main products and their processing in fertilizer technology. Urea is the main component in the fertilizer. It is mostly used in the NPK and other fertilizer. The urea inputs are ammonia plus carbon dioxide. Ammonia will be in the gas liquid form, and ammonia liquid plus carbon dioxide gas. It is gas form. These are the raw materials for the urea production. And there is high concentration nitrogen in fertilizer. It is a high concentration of nitrogen in fertilizer. And in this process is carried out in 170 to 190 degrees Celsius and the pressure is 135 to 145 bar. And these are chemical reaction of urea. This is the carbon dioxide plus ammonia to give ammonium carbonate. After formation of this ammonium carbonate, it will be dehydrated. Dehydrated means reduction of water molecules. It gives H2CO plus H2O. This is the urea. These are the chemical reactions involved in the urea production. And there is a process in two types of process. One is high pressure process and another one is low pressure process. The high pressure process in the urea manufacturing is stripping, condenser and urea synthesis and urea rectifying operations. These are carried out in high pressure. And low pressure operations are evaporation, recovery and prelim. These are done in low pressure. And phosphate fertilizers. In this phosphate fertilizer, the phosphate rock is the main raw material and we are using sulfuric acid and water is the additional raw materials. And there is two type of phosphates available. One is single superphosphate, another one triple superphosphate. This single superphosphate, we are using monocalcium phosphates and gypsum and sulfuric acid. In this single superphosphate, the P2O5 is 16 to 25% in this process used. And in triple superphosphate, monocalcium phosphate is used and P2O5 is 46% used. And it is more concentrate and H3PO4 phosphate rock are used as a raw material. And these are the chemical reaction. The phosphate rock that is C+7 sulfuric acid plus 14 here. This is the superphosphate. This is the reaction. This is a phosphate rock. It's a reacts with sulfuric acid with the water and gives the single superphosphate and plus water. This is the reaction takes in the single superphosphate and the process are two stages and diffusion of sulfuric acid with rock by rapid chemical reaction and diffusion of phosphoric acid into a pores of rocks. These are the two stages. And here triple superphosphate, there are two process and two stage reactors is used in the triple superphosphate. These are the main process of production of phosphate fertilizers. And this is the flowchart of urea production. In this urea production, the raw materials are ammonia and carbon dioxide. And this is ammonia in the liquid phase and carbon dioxide in the gas stage. And composition is ammonia is 3 to 5 moles and carbon dioxide CO2 1 mole. This is the ratio of raw material given in the autoclave reactor. And this is the autoclave reactor and this is flask evaporator and flask drum and vacuum evaporator prelim tower. These are equipments used in this process. And first we have to give a raw material ammonia plus carbon dioxide with a 3 to 1 mole composition. And it mixed together and it passed to autoclave reactor. in this autoclave reactor, there is 185 degrees Celsius maintained in this inside of the reactor, and pressure about to 180 atmospheric pressure. And there is water jacket over the autoclave reactor, because inside the reactor there is more heat will produce, so we have to maintain the heat so that we are giving the cooling water bottom side and getting a hot water outside. This is a cooling, this is for cooling purpose. And this, after that it goes to flash evaporator. Before that we have to add a steam, we have to increase the heat so that we have to give a steam here, and it goes to flash evaporator. In this flash evaporator, this is 140 degrees Celsius maintained, and 27 atmospheric pressure is maintained in the inside of the flash evaporator. And this condensate goes to the, it is the high pressure process, it goes to the recycled solution. That the recycled solution contains ammonium carbamate and ammonia and carbon dioxide and H2O. These are the materials in the condensate. And after the remaining bottom rod, it goes to the flash drum. Flash drum, there is a 1 atmospheric pressure maintaining in the flash drum. After that, here after the flash drum, we get a 60% aqueous urea we can get, and this is in a liquid product. After that, we have to increase the heat, and it goes to the vacuum evaporator. There is a 135 degrees Celsius maintained in the vacuum evaporator. It is for improving the concentration of the solution, so that we are using vacuum evaporation. After a vacuum evaporation, we can get a 95-99% molten urea. This molten urea is in a liquid form, so that we have to convert it into the solid form. So we are passing to the preem tower. These are the preem tower. This is the sprayer, and here we are giving cooling air, and here this way air out, and air and liquid content, it will convert a solid. It is a round small granules. This is urea granules we can get a bottom of the cooling tower. These are the chemical reaction involved in the production of urea, carbon dioxide and ammonia. It reacts together and gives ammonium carbamate, and ammonium carbamate dehydrates and it gives urea plus water. This is the main reaction in the production of urea in fertilizer technology. And these are the reactions involved in superphosphate, as we seen earlier. It is the process of triple superphosphate. And these are main processes in the manufacturing of fertilizers. Thank you.